Stanford University.
We go in the street when one person is shot by a rogue police officer or a system of racism within our police department, and we should. But 250,000 people die every year from poverty. African-American workers make less than a living wage, less than $15 an hour, and in the South, where politicians still pit white workers against workers of color, half of all the jobs pay less than $15 an hour. And the top 400 taxpayers earn an average of $97,000 an hour, and we arrest people and lock them up in this country for protesting for $15. And we keep asking this question that really makes no sense: how much would it cost? Joseph Stiglitz, the Nobel Peace Prize laureate, said, here's the real question: not how much will it cost to fix this, because for the first time in modern history, we actually can settle the question, can we fix it? That's a settled question. The real question is, will we? So Joseph Stiglitz asked this question: how much does inequality cost? How much does it cost to keep inequality active? Ecological devastation, in a simple way put, 4 million families, not just in Flint, 4 million families get up every morning, they can buy unleaded gas or can't buy unleaded water. We don't have the moral capacity. We must know who we are in this moment and not just celebrate the moral movements of the past, but build one. This moment is not about weather and what's going to happen in the next election. This moment is about what's going to happen in America and if America is even going to be possible. I believe we're in fact in the third reconstruction, and America needs more than a new president. We need a moral revolution of values. And we must know that we once again are called to be the conscience of this nation. That's why we started the Poor People's Campaign, the National Call for a Moral Revival, from the bottom up, from the people. Because those 140 million people, they hold the key to setting free this nation. There's too many Democrats walk away from this. Even to this day, we walk away, leave it alone. And we do not even realize that the demographics are such that things have changed in ways that what we saw in Alabama doesn't have to be an anomaly. But far too long, Americans, too many, even good Americans, have accepted the narrative of a conservative, solid South made up of red state that certain party can assume in national election. Drop like a cork those maps. But these maps are an optical illusion created by gerrymandering and voter suppression. These states are not red states. They are voter suppression states and underorganized states and disconnected states. And if we go there and organize, the reason, I know this, I don't know a lot, but I know that if these fusion coalitions were not possible in power, Republicans in the South would not have spent so much money paying lawyers to suppress the vote and turn people against them. This moment is about whether we as a people will reconstruct the heart of our democracy. And right now we're being called to speak with and for the weak and the voices. And Dr. King said, it's true more now than ever today, the dispossessed of this nation. The poor, the poor, white, and Negro live in a cruelly unjust society, but they must organize a revolution. The rejected must lead this revolution. It cannot merely be diets coming down patronizing. That's why in this movement, we're organizing from the bottom up. Whenever we do that in the Poor People's Campaign, the speakers are the people impacted. People have been hurt. They must organize a revolution. We must do it with them, religious leaders, and people who necessarily believe in religion, but believe in the moral law of the universe, and advocates. Organize a revolution, but a revolution can't be against our fellow citizens, as Dr. King said, but against the structures through which the society is refusing to take means which have been called for and which are at hand to lift the load of oppression. This was the voice of our hero in the last years of his life. This was his revolutionary spirit, moving on behalf of the poor and behalf of this nation. This was the King that said, I'm going to take 3,000 people to D.C. and we're going to stay there. Not for one rally, not for one action, but we're going to stay there. And this, my friend, is our calling. To leave this work undone is to negate our claim of love for him.
We need a moral agenda, because some things are not about left and right, but about right and wrong.
right versus wrong. Ward 18 ought to be registered at 18. Yeah. Early voting in every state. Election day is a holiday. Just immigration reform, pathways to citizenship, tribal recognition for First Nation, Native Americans, and Alaskan Native people, end mass incarceration, federal and state living wages, right for all workers to form and join unions, equal pay for equal work, free tuition at public college and university, equitable funding for HBCUs, Medicaid expansion, but then single payer care, universal health care for all, fair and decent housing for all. The dreamer lives on, and we must know who we are, because nothing, 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 absolutely nothing would be more tragic than for us to turn that left. It's moving.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.